Coming to you live from Sleyman Main Stadium in Terre Bay, home of the Mutanteers. This stadium is filled to capacity, and this crowd is feeling it.
Yeah, especially that guy with that sword in his back.
Well, what do you expect? It was free Saber Day for the Mutanteers. 1,000 fans get a rusty dull sword.
And this is going to be a bloody game. The teams are loading their weapons and sharpening their spikes. The Scarolina Panzers battle the Terre Bay Mutanteers. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, man, I scared a chill. I am a hell of an old.
And MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow and my partner Brickhead Mulligan and Mini Bricks. Heard you got a little touch of the mutant bird and pig flu. How you feeling, partner?
Well, the projectile vomiting finally let up, but the monsoon mudslides have begun. If you know what I mean.
I've been literally cramping his brains out all night. He's getting stupider by the hour, if that's even possible.
And the defense jumps outside trying to... If he was still talking, he'd be saying... Psycho killer, qu'est-ce que c'est? Yeah. What the fuck?
I don't even get out of it.
And it's 1st and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6. And he breaks away. And the defense calls the thunderclap dirty trick. Man, that's gotta hurt.
That'll make the hair on your corpse stand straight up.
First and 10. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Yeah, except the zombies. They are freaks.
And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go.
It certainly left skid marks.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last 3 plays! Talk about luck!
And it's 1st and 10. Defense didn't give an inch. No gain on that play. Second down and 10. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Wham!
And it's 1st and 10. Oh man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
2nd down and 5. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
It's first and 10. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. The ref calls a penalty. You know, the MFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
First down and 7.
Hot. Hot 1. Hot 2. Hot. Hot 3.
Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second down and 7.
Hot. Hot 1. Hot 2. Hot. Hot.
Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1.
Hot 1. Hot 2. Hot. Hot. Hot.
And that's a pick. Oh, with a punishing hit.
Is that right, Wim? That penalty makes no sense.
And something ain't kosher here, and I'm not talking about the corned beef with extra mayo. And that'll bring up 3rd. Defense had enough with this rep and jumps off sides to kill him. That'll bring up 3rd and 1.
Hot, hot 1, hot 2, hot, hot.
And he snags it for 6. Touchdown! Touchdown! Should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Well, they went for the easy point. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right. You do it.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's 1st and 10. And playing a dirty trick is always good for an easy kill. First down and forever. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. Second down and long. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is going to have more receptions than the offense. And he bursts into the end zone for the score. What a run!
Hey man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you do. That's right. Hey, what you talking about?
Hey, Bricks, they're going for 2 here. Boom!
Yeah.
kicker.
Ma, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, nice hit! Third down and, well, good luck.
Hot one, hot.
That was equal parts great run and bad defense. Couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot into that one. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life no doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. First and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh man, he really works.
His cleats are caked in blood and boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
First and ten. Second down in a very lot. Oh, look at this guy break tackle. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. He's not going down. And then to first down from a great catch.
What?
Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. First and ten. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Second down and six. And like a monkey trying to fuck a greased football, he gets... And the MFL keeps counting out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Did you just say greatest tits? Where?
That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Up a two. And that'll be second and eight to go.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
A pickup of about three on that play. Third and four.
Hot one, hot two,
chance. He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. Second down and a lot. Oh, he fumbled that one. Everyone loves being on the highlight reel, leaping over a defender, but sometimes you get hit hard and have the ball knocked loose. And it's first and ten. The dance with someone who knows they can negotiate for more money next year.
I call that shake, rattle, and bone.
Well, that should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good. Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten. Just keep pounding the ball right up the gut and you'll tire these guys out. Two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outman.
And it's first and ten. The quarterback rigged the ball to explode, and the defensive player got...
Oh, my God, a man from prison just came out of the field.
That's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. Second down in a mile. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. And he picks up about six on the play. Punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. The cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he snags the punt and looks for open field. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
One speed. Field in front of him. He's at the tackle. Touchdown! And he rips off a game-breaking run for the score. I like this. They're going for two. It in for an easy 2 points. The momentum in this game may be shifting.
Oh, those are just my balls.
Thanks for sharing, Briggs.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, no, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich?
And whoever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
Second and three. With the vicious kill!
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwan Galaxy phone.
The offense is running low on quarterbacks. They have only two left. They might consider running the ball more. And it's first and ten. Revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. That Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
It was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed anyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but yeah, not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I don't really know right now. What day is it?
The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Grim?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
First down and three. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
Second and three. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Third down and three. At this rate, the QB's gonna have more interceptions than completions. Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got dead mutant bingo.
Only one man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. The offense has only one quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
This new QB.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
And it's first and ten. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
Oh, and the quarterback threads. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. It's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts so you can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grin.
Second down and a very lot.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
He can go all the way, and he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
And the easiest play in the league, and he chokes.
Yeah, he's a choker.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and ten. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Ah, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new ones? Oh, man. Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. And this is gonna be a rocket shot to the moon.
QB's fault. If he held the ball spikes up like it was supposed to, the kicker would have never missed.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
Pull that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. My parole officer calls. I was with you last night, Brent.
And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
And that'll be second down and four. Runs hard. First down. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. The teams line up for the kickoff to start the second half. These guys will have to play a lot harder to make it a game. Well, either that or kill and cheat more. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. down in less than a defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Why go for one when you could go for two?
It's always been my philosophy, but Bricks can't even get one. Oh, we're talking about
that. And the defense stops him cold. That play just got blown to hell.
Yeah, it got blown to shit.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. Second down and ten. An all-pro MFL hit.
Ah, that is such bullshit. I got money on this game. These guys need to talk to the ref about those calls. And by talk, I mean stomp them into the ground.
Second down, the side. It's a jailbreak. And the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Ho-ho! Crowd's loving it. First and ten. Look out, that's an all-out attack on the... If this guy could talk before he died, what do you think he'd be saying, Bricks?
Psycho killer! Just to say, what the fuck!
Terror Bay loses at home by forfeit. Well, when's the last time you saw the Mutineers defeated like that, Bricks?
I think there's some people who keep records of it, you know, with computers and stuff.
I like the sound of you not talk.
They battled hard, but still got their butts handed to them.
Gross. I hope there weren't any orc butts involved.
I kind of like orc butts, especially with some Dijon mustard and a smoked pickle relish. Now that's living.
Let's go down to the field and see what the game's MVP thinks of today's outcome. Once again, the folks at Evil SM thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the MicroHard Corporation. They get it right every...